I couldn't stop it. I couldn't do anything.
Stop. Stop it. Calm down.
I'll get back. It's in my head.
Howard, wait.
Father. Father, are you all right?
It's my ankle.
Oh, Jesus, Lord, I think it's broken. Howard, go and get help.
There's no one left. No one's coming to help us.
Please, Howard, fetch help.
The light. They're in the light. I can see everyone in the light. Oh, God. Oh, my God. Help me.
What about the station?
That's shut down too. So there's no way in or out of the valley. They're obviously serious about this flu thing.
Phil doesn't think it's flu at all. He said he's been practicing medicine for 30 years and he's seen plenty of flu, and he said this doesn't feel right at all.
Well, there's nothing of any use on the radio.
Sorry I'm late, everyone. Have you started?
Yes, but to be honest, there's not really that much to discuss. This quarantine is in place. There's roadblocks and everything. No one really seems to know anything, but people are definitely missing. More of them too, not just a couple of old biddies. No one's seen the Sullivans since yesterday, and the house is just sitting there unlocked.
I just got back from the farm. All of Frank's cows died in the night. He's devastated.
Poor man. Hasn't he had enough for one year? First Mary and now this.
Well, if no one's coming in to sort this mess out, we're just going to have to do it ourselves. Barbara, get Phil to do a stock take on medication. Jeremy, put the word out for people to congregate at the village hall. It's best we get everyone in one place for the time being.
Good.
I'll organise supplies. We'll have a lot of hungry mouths to feed. There's plenty at the depot, but well, let's start with what's here in the village. I'll draw up a rota. Charlie, you help me with that?
Anything for you, Meg.
I'll head out into the valley and scoop up the isolated families and check in with Lizzie Graves at the camp. Has anyone seen or heard anything from Stephen Appleton or his wife? Meg? Meg, are you here?
Here. I'm in the lounge.
There are too many empty houses tonight. Most of the village is gone now.
My head's killing me. Have you listened to the phones?
No, I thought they were all dead.
There's a strange kind of static now. I think I heard numbers in it. It sounded like the American woman.
Kate, she's still alive. No one's seen her.
Is Charlie back?
Not yet, no. I'm sorry.
That's all right, Father. Listen, you go on ahead. I'll just rest here a little longer.
Sleep well.
Recording the pattern for 3 hours and so far have accumulated over 3 megabytes of binary data. The pattern does not, at this point, seem to be part of any recognizably closed loop, but there remains symmetry, despite the conflicts. electrical failures all over Tower 6. The light is flowing like liquid. Its sense of purpose is overwhelming. There's something in... Steven? Steven, is that you?
Is everything all right?
Get out of my way.
Where's Kate?
Where do you think she is?
Stephen, what's going on?
Screw Kate. It's all her fault anyway.
What's that mark on your face? Stephen! Stephen!
hasn't even reached the back fence, silly old bugger.
Well, loaves and fishes we can manage,
Father,
but garden
Jeremy,
design is a little beyond.
Might I have a word?
Mrs. Boyles, of course. Meg, will you excuse us, please?
I'll see you back at Charlie's later. Cheerio, Wendy.
I was speaking to Barbara. She said there were some irregularities about Mary's morphine.
Good grief. I mean, those are private medical records. Barbara should know better than to be discussing that sort of thing with you. If Dr. Wade finds out, he'll have no choice but to suspend her. Damn it, Wendy! Your brother is grieving. Mary was sick for a long time, and I'm glad it's over for her. Go and support Frank. He needs you now.
God knows what you did. He sees. I just pray he can overlook Mary's weakness, but you, a man of the cloth,
if you have an issue
you
with...
bring shame on this parish.
If you have an issue with me, I suggest you write to the Bishop of the Diocese. I have parishioners to attend to. Excuse me.
Thank you.
word with them, perhaps. They listen to you.
Well, I really don't see what it has to do with me at all.
The village looks up to you. I just think with what's been happening with Mr. Coles and Mrs. Boughton and the others, that people need somewhere to talk, to feel safe.
Perhaps they don't think that your church is somewhere they feel particularly safe.
I don't need your forgiveness, Wendy. Or theirs. Whosoever thou art that judgest, for wherein thou judgest another, thou condemnest thyself. Romans chapter 2, verse 1.
Beware of practicing your righteousness before other people in order to be seen by them. Matthew chapter 6, verse 1. It's not my judgment you should be worried about, Father. But fine. I'll talk to Barbara. Ask her to put a note up in the surgery about an extra service. Will that do?
Meg, come and have a look at this.
Oh, I don't believe it. Charlie?
Jeremy reckons someone had been raiding all the empty houses. He said a load of stuff had been taken.
What's that?
It looks like someone's been collecting their own supplies.
Bastard!
Well, we've got enough stock in the warehouse to keep the entire village going for months.
We should get a truck.
What, and go and get all of it now?
Yeah, why not?
It's Appleton. It's that bloody crackpot, Stephen Appleton. I'm gonna fucking do him.
Sam, it's fine. We'd better get moving before the weather turns. You come in. We'll swing by the camp and get Rachel on the way back.
Thank you.
away from the main road. Not many people are moving around now.
I was looking for Dr. Wade.
Listen, Frank. I don't know what's happened, but your Stephen seems to think he's responsible.
I reckon he is.
He said, Kate's still up at the observatory, but the gates are locked. Look, Frank, there's going to be a rescue soon, I'm sure of it. They'll send planes or something.
Well, they'll send planes, all right. This pattern of his, we're in the center of it. Which means if they intend to stop it, we're right in the firing line.